Welcome back. You are tuning in to Traders Nation. My pleasure to have back here once again my favorite Bob Beaudine, the power of who? Bob, welcome to Traders Nation. How are you today?
Hey, Kurt, it's Thanksgiving time. Great to be with you.
It is. I tell you, Bob, it's been an exciting year and not so exciting. But listen, I want to talk to you about something. The power of who this year has been a great year for you because it resonates with people. Why is that, Bob? Why does the power of who resonate with so many people? Why is it so big?
Kurt, the most amazing secrets, it seems like the most profound ideas are the simplest, but
right.
Somehow they're the hardest to see. And, you know, people have talked about the power of who is probably one of the biggest ideas that kind of hit the scene for building and growing and sustaining relationships.
Right.
So, you know, I tell people you have to be known to be needed, and you know it's a big point that needs to get in people's in their mind.
Right. Again, right here we are in the middle of Thanksgiving, and with families and friends, and I do consider you a great friend, Bob, and appreciate the conversations we have over this year. Here we are in a year where we're making friends, we're building our who list, aren't we?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we understand because people are now having to circle their wagons. A lot of people in the old Tracy Lawrence, find out who your friends are now identifying their who. You know, when we started talking about this a year ago, my gosh, Kurt, there were a large amount of people, you know, out of a job now. And, of course, you know, the government told us that the recession's over. And,
right.
You know, what happened? There's 15 million people now out of a job.
Sure. All right.
And they don't know where to turn. And that's where this amazing thought that you and I are trying to get into their minds, and that is, especially when we're talking about family, and that is this. What if each of us have been given key relationships in our lives that have been specifically placed there to help us in ways we never imagined?
Right. All right.
So, we could have missed it.
What if somebody's having a difficult time finding their who this holiday season? What words of wisdom do you have for them?
Well, you know, the very first thing that most people are really identifying their who is that they've stopped and forgotten them. I mean, they have 5,000 names that they have on their list. They've stopped talking about, and they don't see their friends and their family as conduits and resources to their dreams.
Right.
And we really got to stop. Your friends and your family are your greatest asset in a time of a crisis.
Right.
And these people will actually introduce you to their friends and family. Does, you know, one of they did this study that's unbelievable, and the question was, does context matter? Does it matter if Kurt introduces me as his friend? And of course it does. They did this study of a guy named Joshua Bell, and he's this concert violinist, the greatest child prodigy, just won the greatest award.
Yeah.
And here was the test. Put this guy who makes $300 a ticket out in Philadelphia on a street corner in street musician clothes,
yeah,
and put a little hat in front of him, would people stop? You know, 1,070 stop, you know, just walked on right by.
Really?
7 people stopped to listen to the greatest violinist of our day. He got $13 in tips. So hold a second. Are people stopping for just resumes sent in wildly to a bunch of people you don't know? No, they're not.
Yeah.
You've got who? You have friends. And then when they recommend you, why? Because references, endorsements, and testimonials, that's what we're looking for.
Wow, Bob, fantastic study. So how can somebody leverage their who without coming across as, you know, using somebody? Because we don't like that, Bob. That's no good. But how can we do that?
Well, the very first thing is if you want friends, you got to be a friend.
Yeah.
I mean, the best way is to help other people today in where they are and kind of reach out. That's the old Zig Ziglar. If you want your dreams to come true, help other people. But here's the biggest flaw that starts right off the bat is that, you know, if I called in you and asked you for help, Kurt, do you help me?
Sure. Oh,
yeah, well, why would you deny me the same joy of helping you?
Right.
See, it never works in reverse. What people really don't understand is that your friends are pre-wired to want to help you.
Right.
They actually do. You know, once you take a place in someone's heart and you haven't called them for 20 years,
yeah,
and you reach out and talk to them, they're going to say, hey, hold a second. Tell me your dream, Kurt. Tell me what you really want to do. Let me see if I know a few people, and I will introduce you.
Sure. Isn't that key, though? Because you said pre-wired, and that's the key word here, isn't it, Bob?
It is. You know, most people don't understand that. I think there's a divine appointment sometimes for friendships.
Yeah.
I mean, the very first time that you and I met, I felt right off the bat this kinship, this thought, this stream of thought that said, oh my gosh, this is my kind of guy. And I just think that some people are missing it. They're out with the wrong who. If you're being tolerated and not being celebrated, you need to change some of your who.
Sure, Sure, I think that's critical, changing some of your who, because let's face it, we all got to start putting our who lists together. And I think isn't that like, you know, you have to surround yourself with who-like people?
Yes. I mean, I tell people all the time, look, I can change your life with three things. What you read, I mean, start reading some good things. What you listen to and who your friends are. I write a story in my book about hog callers. These are people who are never, ever wanting to encourage you on your dream.
Yeah.
You know, we all have these people. They're draining people. We don't even have to talk about them. We see them in our minds.
Right.
And we need to eliminate these people from our lives and just say no.
Right.
We're not going to allow them as this new year starts. Because, look it, you've got to get on to what you're passionate about. There's 15 million people who some of these jobs are just not coming back.
Right.
The cheese has moved.
Yes.
And what happens is that they were really doing a job they didn't really love anyway. It was just a job. It was going to cubicle number 3.
Yeah, it's just
they knew inside that they had something that they do better than anyone in the world. They do it well, and they have to be passionate. Isn't that what really excites people every single day? Passion?
Yeah, absolutely it does, Bob. It's like if you love what you do every day, it's like a holiday, isn't it, Bob?
Oh, it creates great health. I tell people that only the inspired in life inspire. Inspiration fuels this passion, and passion, what does it do? Well, it wins the girl, wins the job, wins the interviews. It does everything, and people have to see that about you when you walk in, because if you walk into an interview and you don't know if you really love it or not, you know, it's like the sign around your head going, beep, 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 don't hire me.
Yeah, it doesn't it go off. I mean, you can tell. For instance, if somebody's uncomfortable, if they're just, you can just downright tell if that is the person or not. They either connect or don't, right?
Right. Yeah, and so I think we have to first start today, and we have to get out over this weekend first. First, when you go to Thanksgiving, you sit around these people, you know, love them, share with them, tell them and ask them for help. I mean, tell them that, hey, you want to help them, how can they do it? Tell them your dreams. You know, we have to revoice our dreams today. That's what I teach people in The Power of Who, is how to get and voice that dream so that your parents and your friends and other people can rally around you, put actual companies' names down, and then we can actually take that to the next step.
Yeah, isn't that the best way to engage somebody, is to throw that out there like that? Right?
Yeah, I mean, if we can all of a sudden say, look it, I've always wanted to do this, and you go,
right.
Oh my gosh, really? Do you know that there's two companies and friends of mine that I went to college with,
sure.
And I could easily introduce you to those two,
yeah,
then those two people are closer to your dream, and then
right.
Inch by inch, we start to do something about it, and we put, actually, because I, you know, there's a line that I say that I think is just critical, and that is that you can never get what you can't see.
Right.
We got to actually see it, and that's why this whole power of forgetfulness is that, you know, if I don't see it, then I'm just waiting for Bob Barker to call, like he's going to actually call me.
Right.
And the guy's retired.
He's retired. He's gone. He's in the Bermuda playing his own game show. Bob, I'm going to let you fill in the blank. If you don't have friends or family around you, you don't have blank. Fill in the spot.
You don't have squat.
That's right. You don't. So now's the perfect time as we come together, as family and friends come together, to get together and give thanks for what we have in our lives. Isn't that the time, Bob?
Oh, yeah. I mean, listen to me. First off, God has a great plan for you. Your family and friends were given to you as gifts. I tell people you're given 12 friends, 3 close, and 1 best.
Yeah.
Now, think about this. This model's worked for years and years. Jesus had 12 friends, 3 close, 1 best.
Sure.
Everyone knows who he is, and 2,000 years later, the guy's still doing deals.
Yeah.
So my point to you is this. Who are your 12? Can you write them down for me? Can you look across and say, my gosh, you know, my sister has always been a great friend of mine.
Right.
You know, that's the story. I mean, recently, a friend of mine came up and said he just got a job. He couldn't believe it. He had 6 interviews. All of them went well until the last person wouldn't meet him.
Mm.
He's totally bummed. He goes home. He doesn't know what to do. And bang, right off the bat, he's sitting with his best friend, his sister, who's a stay-at-home mom with 3 little boys.
Yeah.
And guess what? His sister knows the person he was interviewing with.
She's got who, he's got who. In fact, if you want who, you need to get it today. The Power of Who, you are already, you already know everyone that you need to know. Bob Beaudine's with us today. Bob, it's always a pleasure. God bless you and your family. I do appreciate you. And Bob, we will see you in 2010. I know we'll see you in a big way, too. Bob Beaudine, folks.
All right? Great being with you.
You bet. Bob Beaudine, The Power of Who. Get your who list together. Now more than ever.